So you're outside chasing around that rare Squirtle, but bam, your phone dies. Well, we can't help you catch Pokemon, but we can give you 3 hacks for keeping your phone battery juiced. Alright, before we get into the hacks, here's how your phone battery works. Smartphones, laptops, and Teslas all get their power from rechargeable lithium-ion batteries. All batteries have the same basic 3 parts, a positive electrode called a cathode, a negative electrode called an anode, and a chemical layer called an electrolyte that lets electrical charges flow between the electrodes. In lithium-ion batteries, the electrode combo is usually a lithium-cobalt-oxide cathode and a graphite anode. When you plug in your phone, electrons enter your phone's battery and cause lithium ions to meet up with them at the anode. Once at the anode, the lithium atoms nestle in sites between the graphite's carbon layers. When you unplug your phone, though, the process reverses. Lithium atoms at the anode start losing their electrons. The electrons zip through the circuit, providing the current to run your phone. Meanwhile, lithium ions journey through the electrolyte. They reunite with the electrons at the cathode. These processes keep going until all ions reach the cathode, causing that dreaded flashing battery symbol. Every time you burn through 100% of the battery's charge, which is called capacity, you take the battery through 1 charge cycle. Each cycle inches the battery closer to death by shaving off some of its total capacity. So, here's how to keep your phone's battery charge and life lasting longer with science. Heat does nasty things to lithium-ion batteries, and we're not talking thermonuclear level heat here. We're talking about when you forgot your phone in a hot car or left it in the sun at the beach. As your phone battery gets warm, the heat speeds up the chemical reactions that cause a battery to go kaput. These reactions break down the electrolyte and form products on the anode. This blocks lithium ions from nestling into the graphite. Fewer sites means less capacity, and you'll have to charge your phone more often. Even worse, heat can start a thermal runaway. Once the cobalt oxide gets hot enough, it starts a cycle of reactions that throw out more and more heat. All of this heat starts to boil the liquids in your phone's battery, building pressure until the battery explodes. Lithium-ion batteries don't need to be fully discharged before recharging, unlike nickel batteries. Nickel batteries suffer from the memory effect, meaning that unless they're at 0%, they'll forget part of the capacity when recharged. But lithium ions never forget, and they loathe a full discharge. When you drained your phone to 0, your phone lost more capacity, so your charges won't last as long. So make sure your phone battery doesn't die. If it's on the verge of death, just turn it off. You can tweet us thanks later. Okay, so we really weren't kidding about lithium ions hating it when you let your phone die. If you're leaving a fully discharged battery alone for a while, it could get unstable, like the thermal runaway and possibly blow up kind of unstable. Fortunately for us, modern batteries trip a self-destruct circuit before destabilizing. Unfortunately for us though, self-destructive batteries will never work again. So if you're going on vacation to a foreign country where you won't be using your phone, make sure the battery charge is around 50% before turning it off. And if you're letting it sit for a longer period of time, turn it on about every 6 months to make sure it's charged to 50%. This way, you avoid both self-destruction and capacity loss. With our simple hacks, you can keep your current battery in top shape for the next time you go hunting Squirtle. What features would you like to see in your next smartphone? Let us know in the comments. And hey, thanks for watching.